So good morning, everyone. Today, we are going to start with the first unit of dynamics of machine, that is dynamics of engine mechanism. And in today's class, we are going to discuss the dynamics, or let's say kinematics of piston of the IC engine. Okay, we'll be studying about piston, connecting rod, and so on. So today we will discuss about the piston. So okay, I hope my screen is visible to you. All right. So the topic for today is displacement, velocity, and acceleration of piston. All right. This can be further divided into two types, that is kinematics of slider crank mechanism and dynamics of slider crank mechanism. This SCM stands for slider crank mechanism. Okay. In short, I'll be calling it as SCM. So the dynamic analysis will consider two parts, that is kinematics and dynamics. All right. Kinematics of slider crank mechanism, there are two ways which we can determine this. You have already studied in your previous semester subject, that is graphical approach and analytical approach. All right. And in dynamics, we'll do the approximate analysis and exact analysis of what we have obtained through the kinematic analysis. Okay. So in approximate analysis, only the mass of piston is considered. Okay. And in exact analysis, both the mass of piston and connecting rod are considered. Okay. So again, let me repeat. While determining the displacement, velocity, and acceleration of piston, we'll do the two things, that is kinematics of slider crank mechanism and dynamics of slider crank mechanism. In kinematics, they can be determined by two methods, that is graphical approach and we have analytical approach. These two approaches can be used. And while doing the dynamic analysis, we have approximate analysis and exact analysis. The difference between both these is, in exact analysis, we consider the mass of connecting rod also along with the mass of piston. Okay. So I hope this is clear to you. Let's start with the kinematics of piston, that is kinematic analysis of piston. All right. So in kinematic analysis, as discussed in the previous class, there are three things that we do in the kinematic analysis. That is in kinematic analysis, we determine the motion related data. And what is motion related data? Motion related data is displacement, velocity, and acceleration of any particular link. All right. This you have already studied in theory of machines, but you have studied the graphical approach, right? You might have been drawing the velocity triangle and acceleration triangle, or velocity diagram and acceleration diagram for doing the graphical analysis, right? In this, we'll go with the analytical analysis or analytical approach to determine the displacement, velocity, and acceleration of individual link. Okay. So as you can see this diagram, in this diagram, this AB is the connecting rod. Sorry, this AB is the crank. All right. And that crank has length R. It is rotating with angular velocity omega. Omega is angular velocity in clockwise direction. And the angle which it is forming while rotating is theta. Okay, at any particular instant, this angle is theta. All right. So link AB is what? Crank. Now this link BC, this is connecting rod. and this connecting rod has length L. Okay, this has length L. When this crank has rotated by angle theta, this connecting rod has been rotated by angle beta. Okay, so the angle of crank is denoted by theta and the angle of connecting rod is denoted by beta. The length of crank is R, the length of connecting rod is L. All right, now this is your piston. Okay, and we know that this piston moves in linear direction, that is it does a reciprocation motion, and this crank does a rotary motion. Okay, at some given point, okay, so this all is clear to you. So when the piston is at top dead center of the cylinder, okay, when it is at top dead position, the position of the piston was at C dash. Okay, when the piston is at TDC, top dead center, or inner dead center, the position of piston was at C dash. And after some time, when the crank rotated at angle theta, reached at angle theta by its angular velocity of omega, this piston moved from C dash to C. Okay, so let's say that this distance is X. From C dash to C, this distance is X. When the piston had a linear motion of distance X, the crank rotated with angle theta and the connecting rod rotated with angle beta. Okay, so theta is nothing but angular displacement of crank. What is L? L is written over here, length of connecting rod. R is length of crank. And the ratio of length of connecting rod to length of crank is L by R. So this is very important ratio. We'll discuss it in few minutes. And to standardize it, its value is generally from 4 to 6. That is, length of connecting rod will be 4 times of radius of crank, or 5 times of radius of crank, or 6 times. So generally this ratio L by R is kept between 4 to 6 for practical purposes. All right. Now, this piston has displaced from C dash to C, and we are interested to find out this value X. Okay, this displacement X. How much is this displacement? Okay. So how will you determine this distance X? What we can do is, we know this distance from C dash to A. You know, this A is fixed point. Okay. And this IDC is the top limit, and this ODC, that is outer dead center. IDC is inner dead center, and ODC is outer dead center. So these are two dead centers equivalent to top dead center and bottom dead center of the piston. Okay, so piston cannot move out of this, and piston cannot move beyond this. Okay, so this distance C dash A, let me call it one, and this distance CA, okay, let me call it as two. So if we subtract this distance one from two, we'll get this value of X, right? So this way we can determine the displacement done by piston. All right, so this is what is written over here, that displacement of piston X is equals to CC dash, right? This CC dash. And how we can calculate this CC dash? We have taken one fixed point. We'll calculate this value. Okay. Then we'll calculate this value and subtract this one from this one to get this much value. That is displacement X. So I hope this is clear. So this is what is written over here, that CC dash can be written as C dash A minus CA. What is C dash A? C dash A is this distance. Okay. And CA is this distance. Right. Okay. Now, what is C dash A? C dash A can be calculated as L plus R. How L plus R? When this piston is at C dash, this point B is somewhere over here. Okay. And this will be your point B. When the point B will be over here, that is when the piston is at C dash, that is at IDC. When it is at IDC, its position will be something like this. From here to here, there will be your crank. From crank to this C dash will be your connecting rod. Okay. So this C dash A is nothing but L plus R. Okay. And how will you calculate this CA? Now, what is the value of this CA? Okay. So it is calculated with the help of sine law. Okay. So you already know what is sine law. That is, if this is a triangle, its side is A, this side is B, and this side is C. Okay. And this is angle theta. This is right angle, right? And this is angle beta. Okay. So what does the sine law says? Sine law says that the ratio of side and opposite to the sine angle are equal. That is, A upon sine beta is equals to B upon sine theta is equals to C upon sine 90. Okay. So this is what is sine law. So we need to calculate this distance, this total distance. So we have two right triangles. Let me name this point as Z. Okay. This point is Z. You want to calculate this distance CZ. So how can we calculate CZ? CZ will be, this is 90 degree, right? So what can we write? L upon sine 90, okay, will be equals to this CZ upon, let's say this angle is sine 90 minus beta. So what is sine 90 minus theta? It is cos theta. Okay. So CZ will be equals to CZ CZ upon this side divided by sine of this angle. And what is this angle? This angle is 90 minus beta, because this is 90, this is beta, and this is 90 minus beta. Okay. So CZ upon sine 90 minus beta means cos beta. Cos beta. Okay. And by sine law, this ratio will be equals to, this ratio will be equals to L upon its opposite angle, sine of opposite angle, that is sine 90. So L upon sine 90. L upon sine 90. Okay. And we know that sine 90 is equals to 1. Okay. So this value becomes 1. And what will be this CZ? CZ is equals to L cos beta. This cos beta will go here. So this CZ will be equals to cos beta. Okay. So this value is CZ. So CZ is equals to cos beta. Okay. So we have calculated this distance. Let's say this is, N. This CZ is N, and now we want to calculate this value M, that is AM. Okay, so again, let me draw it again. So this point is Z. Okay, we wanted to calculate this entire value AC. Why we want this AC or why we want this CA? Because CA is required over here. So we have broken this CA into two parts, that is CZ and AZ. CZ we calculated by this triangle, this right triangle. All right. So CZ came out to be L cos beta. Similarly, in this right triangle, let me change the pen color. Okay. In this right triangle, BZA. All right. We need to calculate this value. Let's say this is M. AZ is equals to M. So how can we calculate M? By the help of sine law. What does the sine law says? That R upon sine 90. This is the side R and opposite to this angle is 90. So R upon sine 90. Okay, sine 90 is 1. R upon 1 is equals to this M. What is the opposite angle of M? This one. Okay. And how much is this angle? Sine 90 minus theta. Since this is 90 degree, this is angle theta. So this angle will be sine 90 minus theta. 90 minus theta. And according to sine law, that R upon sine 90 is equals to M upon sine 90 minus theta. And what is sine 90 minus theta? It will be cos theta. Okay. So this way, this M comes out to be M is equals to R cos theta. So this is what is written over here, R cos theta. So the value N plus M is nothing but L cos beta plus R cos theta. Okay, and we calculated this with the help of property of triangle, that is sine law. All right, so let me repeat again. We wanted to calculate the displacement of piston, which is denoted by x. X is nothing but cc dash, this distance cc dash. Now this cc dash is equals to c dash a minus ca. C dash A is nothing but L plus R. Okay, and C dash A is nothing but L cos beta plus R cos beta, R cos theta. How did we get these terms? By calculating this entire distance. So we cannot calculate this entire distance in single go. That's why we divided this distance from here to here in two parts, okay, M and N. And with the help of sine law, we determined that M is equals to L cos beta. What is L? L is length of connecting rod. And N is equals to R cos theta. What is R? R is length of crank, radius of crank. Okay. So this way we calculated these values. All right, I hope this is clear to you. Why we did this? Because length of connecting rod is fixed, which is known. Radius of crank is fixed, which is known. This angle theta and beta can be calculated. We can measure the angle theta, then we can calculate the angle beta also. All right. So by rearranging this equation, that L from this, L will be equals to N into R. Okay, so we have written it in that form, that L is equals to N multiplied by R. And over here also, L is equals to N multiplied by R. So displacement X becomes NR plus R minus NR cos beta plus R cos theta. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. Now let's move forward. Now, this is saying from triangle ABC, sine theta upon L is equals to sine beta upon R. That is by the help of sine law. Where is triangle ABC? This is our triangle ABC. Okay, so when we apply sine law in this, it becomes R upon sine beta is equals to L upon cos beta, cos theta. Or we can take its reciprocal also, sine theta upon L is equals to sine beta upon R. Okay, why we are doing this? Because we want to eliminate, or we want to bring all the this equation only in terms of two unknowns, that is R and theta. Okay, we want to eliminate beta. We already eliminated L by help of this equation. Now we want to eliminate beta. Okay, so beta will eliminate with the help of this sine rule. So sine beta becomes L by R sine theta, and L by R is nothing but N. So since it is R by L, so it will become 1 upon N. So sine beta is equals to sine theta upon N. Okay, also we know, this is a very well known equation to everyone, that sine square beta plus cos square beta is equals to 1. Cos beta can be written as under root 1 minus sine square beta. Okay, and what is sine beta? It is sine theta upon N. So it becomes cos beta is equals to sine square theta upon N square. Cos beta becomes, we have taken N outside, so it becomes 1 by N under root N square minus sine square theta. Now this cos beta will be equated in equation number 1. This will be put in equation number 1. Where is equation number 1? This is equation number 1. Okay. We will put the value of beta as, we'll put the value of beta as sine theta 1 upon N under root N square minus sine square theta. So when you substitute that, we get NR plus R into NR multiplied by this whole cos beta is replaced by this 1 by N. N square minus sine square theta plus R cos theta. When you rearrange this equation, you will get X is equals to R N plus 1 under root of N square minus sine square theta plus cos theta. Okay. When you rearrange this equation, you will get it like this. And this is equation number A. This equation number A is the equation for position of crank or displacement of crank. So at any given angle theta, we can determine how much piston has moved from its top dead center. Okay. So, and this equation is in terms of two unknowns, that is R and theta. Okay. We have eliminated L from the equation, and we have eliminated beta from the equation, and written and brought it in terms of theta and R. All right. Okay. So I hope this is clear to you. We can further simplify this equation. How? By doing some approximation. Now you see what can be the maximum value of N. Its maximum value can be 6. Okay, because here we have already discussed that this value N practically lies between 4 to 6. So what can be its maximum value? Its maximum value can be 6. It will not go above that. Okay, so this N square becomes 36. And what is the maximum value of sine theta? Sine theta varies from 0 to 1. So sine theta, its maximum value is 1. So we have substituted those values. That is 6 square minus 1 square is equals to under root 35. Okay. So which is equivalent to under root 36. These two values are very close. So what we can conclude from this is, this under root n square minus sine square theta, this value under root n square minus sine square theta can be equivalently written as under root of n square. Okay, by this mathematical approximation, we can write n square minus sine square theta under root is equals to under root of n square. And this under root of n square will be nothing but n. Okay, this will be n. So therefore, this equation can be reduced in simple terms. That is, we have eliminated this value, or we have reduced this entire value, that is under root of n square minus sine square theta, to what? To simply n. Okay, and we'll keep it in this equation. So we'll get the approximate value that of displacement. That is, x is equals to r multiplied by n minus 1 minus n plus cos theta. Okay, so instead of remembering this big equation of displacement, we can use this equation also. Okay, that is x equals to r n plus 1 into minus n plus cos theta. All right, and you already know in physics, you have already studied that x is equals to r into 1 minus cos theta is equation of simple harmonic motion. Okay, so if connecting rod is long enough, the value of n will be high and the piston will execute simple harmonic motion. See, let me just simplify this for you. This x is understandable, r is also understandable, and this entire value is equivalent to 1, and this value is equivalent to cos theta. Okay, so this is standard equation of simple harmonic motion, that x is equals to r into 1 minus cos theta. Okay, and this equation is equivalent. Hello, am I audible? Hello. Okay. So this becomes equation of simple harmonic motion. Well, this is this is generally asked in the interviews, that when will a piston execute simple harmonic motion. So its answer is simple, that when the length of connecting rod is long enough, so the value of n will be high. What is n? N is ratio of length of connecting rod to length of piston, that is L by R. N is equals to L by R. So when the connecting rod is long enough, the piston will execute simple harmonic motion. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. So we'll stop our discussion today over here. Thank you, everyone.